study following 10,000 Norwegian men for 40 years found that those eating berries more than 14 times a month were more likely to be alive at the end of the study. Higher intake of anthocyanins, the brightly colored pigments in berries, has been associated with anti-inflammatory effects, but these are all just associations. You can't prove cause and effect until you put it to the test. A double-blind, randomized, placebo-controlled study found that blueberry smoothies could turn off inflammation genes. This is measuring the expression of pro-inflammatory genes in white blood cells taken from individuals before and after 6 weeks of drinking placebo smoothies with no blueberries. They got worse over time. 6 weeks later, more inflammatory chemicals pouring out, whereas the blueberry group started out about the same at week zero. But 6 weeks of daily blueberries and the expression of inflammatory genes, such as IL-6, went down. Strawberries, sweet Bing cherries, black raspberries, extracts of goji berries, and Indian gooseberries, amla, has also been shown to decrease inflammatory markers in interventional trials. Have people eat a largely unhealthy breakfast, including a bagel with cream cheese, margarine, egg, and a glass of milk, and the rise in C-reactive protein and IL-6 over the subsequent 6 hours was less when just 10 grams of strawberry powder, equivalent to 5 large strawberries, was added to the meal. A cup of blueberries was able to significantly blunt the IL-6 spike after a ham and cheese sandwich, and the same with 2 cups of raspberries versus a sausage and eggs breakfast. The same amount of banana, however, was no match, unable to stop a triplet of IL-6 levels within 4 hours. Why did the raspberries work whereas bananas didn't? Maybe it's the antioxidants. Free radicals can disfigure proteins in our bodies to the extent they become unrecognizable by our immune systems to the point that our body attacks them as foreign. The inflammatory autoimmune response this triggers may be prevented, however, by saturating our bodies with sufficient antioxidants. Food selection based on high total antioxidant capacity improves endothelial function. High antioxidant fruits and vegetables, such as berries and greens, have been found to douse systemic inflammation significantly better than the same number of servings of more common low antioxidant fruits and veggies, such as bananas and lettuce. What about apples? Not only associated with all sorts of benefits in observational studies, but proven to improve risk factors in randomized controlled trials, including inflammation, but the data is mixed. 6 months of a half cup a day of dried apple rings significantly lowers CRP levels, though the same drop happened in the control group who instead ate about half a cup of prunes a day. Freeze-dried apple powder flopped completely. Eating 3 fresh gala apples, however, appears to lower inflammation both acutely within 6 hours and over time. 6 weeks of 3 galas a day lowered fasting levels of IL-6, though 4 weeks of twice as many champion variety apples, a cross between Cox and Golden Delicious, didn't seem to have any effect. What about grapes for inflammation? Neither raisins nor powdered grapes appeared to help. What about drinking berries? Sipping red wine for 6 to 12 weeks did not affect lower inflammation compared to gin, water, or abstention, and acutely, 2 to 3 glasses of red or white wine can make things worse, increasing IL-6 levels by about 50% within 6 hours compared to a non-alcoholic beverage. However, red or purple grape juice may help. Antioxidant supplements failed miserably. No anti-inflammatory benefit was found for antioxidant vitamins, minerals like vitamin C, E, beta-carotene, or selenium, which brings us back to the bright red, blue, purple anthocyanin plant pigments. Dozens of randomized controlled trials on anthocyanin-rich supplements, mostly berry extracts, have demonstrated anti-inflammatory effects. This may be why red-fleshed plums beat out yellow-fleshed apricots in reducing CRP blood levels, or why even super healthy fruits like mangoes may be powerless against the inflammation caused by a sausage and egg McMuffin, whereas a half dozen studies combined show pomegranates, a fruit packed with ruby red anthocyanins, can bring down inflammation over time. The anti-inflammatory effects of berries are so potent, you can feel it if you push yourself. Check out my video, Reducing Muscle Soreness with Berries. As I note in Watermelon for Sore Muscle Relief, eating 2 cups of watermelon prior to intense physical activity was also found to significantly reduce muscle soreness. The researchers concluded that functional compounds in fruits and vegetables can play a key role in the design of new natural and functional products, but why design new products when nature's already designed everything you need? Unfortunately, chronic watermelon consumption, giving people a whole watermelon and a gallon bag of pre-cut watermelon every week for 12 weeks, did not seem to affect levels of inflammation. Optimizing recovery from exercise is considered the holy grail of exercise science, but what about discernible effects on inflammatory conditions such as arthritis? Tart cherries may be helpful in treating gout. Delicious dietary treatments are much welcomed, as some gout drugs can cost $2,000 a dose, carry no clear-cut distinction between non-toxic, toxic, and lethal doses, or can cause a rare side effect in which your skin detaches from your body. Of course, the best way to deal with gout is to try to prevent attacks in the first place with a more plant-based diet and lower alcohol consumption. Strawberries were pitted against the most common inflammatory joint disorder, osteoarthritis of the knee. Osteoarthritis patients were randomized to get about a pint and a half of strawberries a day for 12 weeks, and not only did inflammatory markers plummet, they experienced significant reductions in constant pain, intermittent pain, and total pain. The first clinical study of the effects of berries on human arthritis found that a simple dietary intervention could have a significant impact on pain, inflammation, and overall quality of life. Surprisingly, blueberries didn't seem to have the same effect. Despite the spin in the title, 12 weeks of about 4 servings of blueberries a day had no significant benefit compared to placebo. They used conventional highbush blueberries, though, which tend to have less antioxidant power than strawberries, and significantly less antioxidant and anti-inflammatory activity compared to wild or lowbush blueberries.